One of you asked me a question in the comments and it goes like this. I recently updated the firmware on my console and ever since I did that, every time I turn it on or load a scene, the main fader will get turned all the way down and it really bothers me. Why is that happening? Isn't the main fader supposed to be saved with the rest of the scene? Yes, it is. So why is it getting turned down? I understand your frustration, but let me tell you something, my friend. This is not a bug, it's a feature. I'm serious. It's called Safe Levels. It's in the configuration page. So I thought, why not go through the configuration page with you so you know what all these settings do and stop being frustrated. By the way, if you're still running the old firmware, please update your console. There's literally no benefit to staying on the old firmware. So update it. It only takes 2 minutes. Okay, let's go to the setup and scroll over to the configuration page and start with the pop-ups. A pop-up is a dialog box that comes up to you and says, do you really want to do something? And you either confirm it or cancel. So the general pop-ups are for things that don't break the scene, like linking to channels or loading a preset. So if I want to link these channels, I will click here, select, then go to the homepage and link. It asks me, do you want to link channel 15, channel 16? I can hit confirm or cancel. Now, if this is turned off and I link the channels, it will link immediately without asking me. I like to keep it on because I like the console to ask me to confirm things because sometimes I click on things accidentally without meaning to do it. So it's always good to ask me. Overwrite is for deleting things, presets or scenes or saving over them. So if I want to save over this scene and click save, it will ask me, do you want to overwrite it? So whatever I did on the console will be saved in the place of this scene. If I don't, I'll click cancel. But if this is off and I go to save a scene and hit save, it saves it. It doesn't ask me if I want to overwrite it. And that's dangerous. I like to keep it on all the time. So it always asks me if I want to override or save something. Load scene means that you have to confirm before loading a different scene because when you load a scene, you have a slight audio dropout. The outputs are muted for a fraction of a second. So it's always good to ask you if you really want to load it. Right now it's off. I'm loading scenes and it's loading without asking me. I like to keep it on. So if I want to load a scene, it asks me, do you want to load? Yes, I want. Okay. Next, the select preferences. Return to last means that if I go to the EQ, for example, and I hit again the view button, and it goes back to whatever I was on, whatever page I was using. And that's good. I like it. If you don't, you can turn it off, and it stays where it is. It doesn't go back to the previous page. Follow bank means that if I'm selecting a fader right here, on the physical location of the fader, and I go to a different page, it will select that other fader. Right now it's turned off, so I'm still here. But if it's turned on and I go to a different page, now it's selecting this channel. I don't like to have it on because I don't want the console to select channels for me. I want to select them. So I'll keep it off. Fader select, they say that if you move a channel, but you don't really have to move it, you only have to touch it. See? And it's selecting the channels. Again, I don't like this because I don't want to accidentally select a channel and work on a different channel that I'm currently working on. It confuses me, so I keep it off. Okay, now, this scene go next means that if it's turned on and if you click go on a scene, which means if you load a scene, it will automatically select the next one. So you only have to click now or go. Okay, you don't have to select the next one. It does it for you. It doesn't really matter to me, so I'll keep it off. And this is what we talked about in the beginning of the video, safe main levels. This is done on purpose, so you don't accidentally blow out your speakers if you turn on your console and there's loud sound coming out of the outputs. If it's turned on and I turn off the console right now, and I turn it on again, then the main fader right now, when it turns on, will go down. See? Now, if you are certain that things are getting turned on in the correct order, which means mixer is turned on first and then the speakers are turned on last. And the level of the main fader is important to your setup. You don't want it to change. Then yeah, sure, turn off the safe main levels. That's a safety feature. It's up to you. But if you're not sure how things are getting turned on and you don't want to blow out anything, keep it on. Now safe main levels is off. So I will reboot the console. Confirm. And if you look at the main fader right here, as it turns on again, it will stay exactly at the same place and it will not be turned down. See? Problem solved. Let's continue. 12-hour clock. That's purely personal preference. It's the clock up here. 12 hours means that it goes to 12 and you have AM and PM. And if you turn it off, it means that this is now a 24-hour format without AM and PM. I like the 12-hour format. That's up to you. Do whatever you want. Hard mutes. When you have mute groups, right here, you have these channels assigned to a mute group and it's muting them. If hard mute is on, it means that if I physically muted these and I click the mute group, it does not unmute it accidentally. Right? So this is physically muted. It will not change based on the mute group. I like to keep it off. It's up to you. DCA groups. Also, this is for the mutes. If I have channels assigned to this DCA, right, and I mute it, it will mute the channels. But if this is off, even if the DCA is muted, it will not mute the actual channels. Okay, I like to keep it on. Invert LEDs. This might confuse you. Because if it's on, everything is muted now, but it's not actually muted, it's on. If you come from another brand of consoles, some of them have on buttons instead of mute buttons. So if it's lit up in red, it means that there is signal, it is on, it is unmuted. If it's not lit up, it means that it is muted. Okay? If you've only used this console and are not used to the other one, don't touch this, keep it off, okay? Because it will confuse you. Now, show view. Show view is when you click the view button on the show control section right here and you see something right here. This is to choose what you want to see first. I have it on scenes because when I click show on the view on the control, I want to see the scenes, right? But if I change it to cues, then when I hit view right here, it will show me the cues first. And you can scroll over. But this is just to quickly either show you the scenes or cues or snippets. I like to keep it on scenes because that's more efficient for me. Now, the recorder view, you have 2-track and 32-track. 2-track is the USB recorder right here. So if I click view, that's the recorder. 32-track is if you have the sound card that uses SD card and records 32 tracks individually, multi-track, and you can record and do virtual playback on it. I don't have it, but if you have that, then when you click view on the recorder, and if you have that selected, it will show you the page of that card. Okay, I'll keep in mind on 2-track because I don't have that other card. Now, the link preferences. This is important. Delay and head amp link is for the input of the channel. So the channel itself, right, has a gain, correct? Trim, gain. And when you link channels together, I'll hit link. It links the gain and it also links the input delay. You have here input delay. If you want to align things, so you can turn it on and click on it. This preference means that you are linking the gain and the input delay of the channels. EQ link simply links the EQ you do on the channel to the other channel if you have a stereo linked channel or stereo linked buses. Dynamics is the compressor.
And also the gate, although what's called dynamics on this console is only the compressor, but don't be confused, both the compressor and the gate are getting linked.
Fader and mute link, if this is turned off, means that even if the channels are linked together, the other fader will not go up with it and the mute will not mute with it. Okay, so this is turned on. The fader will move together and the mute will also mute the other one. Okay, keep these on. Now the mono center master level follows left, right. This is if you're using subs on the mono center bus. You turn it on. Now the mono center level, not the fader, but the level of that bus will follow the main fader. It's not independent anymore. If you turn it off, now the level of the mono center bus is independent of the mains. So you can have the mains all the way down and this is still giving sound. It's better to turn it on if you're using subs on the mono center bus, but it's up to you. Now, panning mode, left, right, plus sub or left, center, right. If you're doing music, keep it left, right, plus sub. That's the way to go. Left, right means that if you're panning channels, let's say I select this channel and I'm panning it left and right. If I pan it in the center exactly, it will go out of both speakers equally. And you'll have a phantom center image because you don't have actually a center speaker. Left, center, right means that you actually have a center speaker. And if it's panned in the center, it doesn't go out of the left and right speakers. It only goes out of the center speaker. This is more for theaters and plays. If you're doing music, just stay on the left, right, plus sub. Now, this is also an important thing. A lot of people complain when they update their console that their faders become slow. What happens to the faders? They used to be blazing fast, right? You can turn on fast faders and it will ask you to reboot the console. So we will reboot it and wait. It takes quite a bit of time, but now the faders are blazing fast. That's what you're used to. That's great. You can make them fast. But this is just, they did this only to make them last longer. Because if they are that fast, they risk slipping the belt that is attached to the motor of the fader. It will slip off. And lastly, we have the bus configuration presets. This is not really necessary, but if you're in a pinch and you don't want to manually configure each bus independently, you can just go right here and select either all 16 pre-fader buses or all 16 post-fader buses or 8 pre-fader and 8 post-fader or 10 pre-fader and 6 post-fader. Wow, I've never talked so much in one take. Anyway, if you found this video helpful, hit the like button. I would appreciate that very much. Thank you and click right here on the video shown on the screen right now. That's what YouTube thinks is best for you and you'll enjoy the most. So click here and I'll see you in the next video.